What is going on, guys, and welcome back to another match day vlog. I've got my Chelsea scarf on and the Chelsea crest. Wait, hold on, we'll get there eventually. Chelsea crest out in force today. We are in sunny Manchester once again for the vlogs. This time Chelsea take on Manchester United in the biggest game of the season so far. It is the biggest game of my season ever. Living in Ireland, it's always the biggest game when you play Manchester United. You always want to get one over on the rest of the country. Today, I'm optimistic we could get something, but we are at Old Trafford. Old Trafford is known for draws this season. Draws after draws after draw. So my prediction for today is a 2-2 draw. We arrived in Manchester really early. As in, like, why did I get up at that time? Only for Chelsea early. So I made a short trip on the tram from Manchester to Bury, and we are currently heading to Gig Lane, the home of the mighty Bury Football Club. I think the nickname is the Shakers, so the mighty Shakers, if you will. Nothing will probably be open since it's Easter Sunday, but I just wanted to have a look at the ground, and then, yeah, see what's in store. I'm going to take £2 off my list today. Mighty Gig Lane, and not a lot going on today. I am going to try get inside somehow, just look at the pitch, maybe just take a picture, because I'd like I said take more football grounds off my list, take more lower league grounds off my list, so, you know, the regular Old Trafford and Etihad and Stamford Bridge. But so from the outside it looks pretty decent. Gig Lane, Bury FC, you let me down. Shout out to Middlesbrough, you know, for actually letting me go in and have a look at their stadium a couple of years back. But Bury, come on, man. You let me down. You really, really let me down. I was hoping to, you know, show you guys bits of Gig Lane. I got to show you the outside of it, but that's not what I want to bring you. I want to bring you the insides of stadiums. Obviously, I could have just gone to a match, but I'm not playing today. So, bit of a disappointment making the trip out here, but it's another ground I can sort of, kind of, tick off my list. Just around the corner from Old Trafford now, I'm there.
You
doing? Yeah, it's a vlog.
Ah, a vlog.
Yeah.
What are you over?
Yeah, that's... what's your name?
Marco.
Marco. This is Marco. We met him on the tram here. And yeah, he's a fan of Juve, he doesn't have a ticket though.
Fino alla fine, forza Juventus.
No. Yeah, as I said, just around the corner from Old Trafford. I really don't know what I'm going to do for the next couple of hours. It's something like a 11:30, and I have no idea where the away pub is whatsoever. I really am in the doldrums now, outside Old Trafford. A theatre of dreams of some of the theatres of nightmares for others. I've always wanted to come to this game, living in Ireland. Every single person you bump into is a Man United fan. They are a cancer on Irish society. And to be here, it's actually just, it's a game I've always wanted to do because I'm a Chelsea fan living in Ireland. This is a pilgrimage for most Irish people. Not for me, I'll be in the away end today. And I can't believe this game I've been wanting to do like my whole life. Yeah, I'm only 17, but still, that's a long time, 17 years, if you really think about it. I'm buzzing to be here. Match still hours away. Look where I am, inside Old Trafford. I cannot believe I'm here. Security check-ins was a nightmare. My God, it was the worst check-in I've ever had at a football match. And I was at the Euros, and there were terror threats. My God, it was ridiculous. Now that I'm inside, I've grown in confidence. Early on, I would have said Manchester United might nick it. But right now, I'm going to go for a 2-1 win for Chelsea. Eden Hazard, Diogo Costa, and Zlatan Ibrahimovic just scored for Manchester United. Pretty surreal right now, being in Old Trafford, not because it's Manchester United or anything like that. It's because I've always wanted to go to this game. Half the country, Ireland, supports Manchester United. To get one over on these lot would be absolutely amazing. It would make my year. Oh, I've always hated Manchester United since I was young. Oh, brings so much anger out of me. When I saw the stadium the first time, I was like, oh, I can see my blood boil. I can't wait for this kickoff now. 15 minutes to kick off now. The crowd is filled up massively. The away end is pretty full now. And then, as I said, Begovic starts for Chelsea. Could be rocky. I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw now. All my bets have been thrown out the window already. I'm going to go for a 1-1 draw. Look at this place, man. Look at it. Look how big it is. I'm slightly in awe, slightly terrified at the same time. Pretty poor. No one has really, done anything in the game whatsoever. We've just given the ball away again. Valencia, Lingard. Lingard holds it up well. Brilliantly, actually, compared to him. Valencia tries to switch it to Torreira. Right, up to a time again with Ashley Young coming on the left. Oh, it's coming too. Oh, one of those dangerous balls. I hate Ashley Young crossing it, but to Fellaini. Hands off him, Dave. Hands off him. Ball didn't go out, still with Valencia now on the right hand side. Hazard wins.
Yeah,
back
nice.
To Dave. Pass it. Oh, tried to clear, but hits Fellaini. There's been a worse performance than Chelsea this match, and it goes to the referee. Very, very poor with some of the decisions. He's been giving them for no apparent reason whatsoever. We still haven't really threatened whatsoever. It's kind of starting to be like a closed game. Still a great voice for the Chelsea fans. Think about Matthew Arling in the blue army. He looks creative and we're not going to create anything. That's the way this game's gone. Cahill, it's cost it. Surely foul. That isn't. That's what I'm on about. Poor refereeing decisions again. Gabriel Reed, just give it back to Begovic for God's sake. That's a terrible ball back to Begovic. Just manages to control it. Oh, jeez. This is really, really poor football from Chelsea. Every time Chelsea win the ball back, the referee gets a free kick to Manchester United. I thought Kante won it back fairly there. I'm guessing we're on. United have a free kick. This place is actually so alive at the moment. Absolute havoc. Little was a star. Yeah, he dealt with. Then he slid across the ball in and it hit off one of the Chelsea players, looping over Begovic to hit the roof of the net. It's the first corner of the game, actually. Rashford right in front of us. Here we go.
Back up. Oh,
5 seconds of this half left. It's another free to United. It's actually just unreal how many frees they've gotten. We still look from the side, if that goes to Costa, looks like he's unfit, unprepared. Where's the Costa we all know and love, who was destroying defenders at the start of the season? Well, that's still like that. Well, it didn't go out for some reason. Oh my god! David Luiz, come on. Pedro, still running. Are you playing Pedro? Oh, Pedro, my man, Pedro. Hazard, Wallace. Oh! Our best chance of the game from long range. Did not challenge the keeper whatsoever there, but at least we got a shot now. 2 minutes added on time. Game over, United lead 2-0. I'm going to get my first defeat as a Chelsea fan of the game. A horrible deflection off David Luiz. It's 2-0 to United now. It looks like really old again with revenge over Chelsea. United fans are shouting mad. Who got the bloody goal? 2-0 Chelsea. They are title challengers as well. 2-0. Terrible one.
Standing ovation from Trafford and really deserves it.
game was better for me. It's very passionate from Chelsea, especially with the likes of Costa. That looks been shocking. It really has been a terrible performance from Chelsea. Worst referee ever. Oh, 75,272 people at Old Trafford today. Oh, what can I say about terrible, terrible performance from Chelsea? We went to the Emo, trying to battle for the title. Well, Louis, what are your thoughts on the game? I've given my thoughts on your channel.
Okay. What's the language barriers like? Am I allowed to be angry, or can I be? Shall I be eloquent like I can be?
You can do whatever you want.
Okay, we're fucking dog shit, mate. That's just brutal, mate. I think that. Obviously, you can't put it all down to Antonio Conte. I think that obviously it just shows that we have a lack of squad depth.
Yeah, I hadn't brought it up before, but like you're kind of hitting the hammer with the nail.
I'm hitting the nail on the head.
Yeah, there you go. Because you look at Man City, Man United. Look at the squad that Man United have.
Yeah.
If you look at that squad that Man United have, they can take off Rashford, who demolished our defence, and bring on Zlatan Ibrahimovic.
That is true. But even so, Mourinho was baiting for blood, and he's got what he wanted. So now that puts his season up, and even though you're saying we have all these players, we do have the capability and we do have the players on the bench to bring off, because, you know, people have said that. I mean,
I thought Mickey should have got a chance today.
My heart says yes, however my head says Michy Batshuayi is still a little bit too light, whatever the friend.
Did you see Costa today? We would have been better off having Michy Batshuayi there.
We'd be better off having the Snapchat guys. We'd be better off. There's a lot of work that needs to be done. Personally, I think the way that Costa goes on, the way that more stories come out, more news, email as well, just go. Yeah, pretty much. But it's something we'll have to see what happens. But obviously, with this system, we clearly need a lot more depth, and we don't have it.
In the airport now, but going to board. Well, not going to Bournemouth in Manchester, but going to get my flight back home to Dublin. We're cut off twice with Louis, but I'll leave a link in the description of a video that we did on 100% Chelsea that basically goes through what we were trying to say and trying to get the message across. I enjoyed the day, right? But the performance wasn't what it would have been. If we tried our hardest and we lost 2-0, I would have been happy. But I felt like a lot of the players didn't try. A lot of players didn't even come over and applaud, which really annoyed me. But happens sometimes. It was a really good trip, in fairness, apart from the result, of course. But I am going to end the vlog here. As always, guys, give the video a thumbs up, share it around on social media, And remember, subscribe.